So we're looking at requests, how we can use it with Python to operate on Cisco DevNet. Cisco DevNet is a brand name for how to configure devices via an API, so network configuration and automation. And here we've got the developer.cisco.com webpage, and what I found is the sandbox, which is an environment which allows you to experiment, basically, and you can experiment with some Python code. So what's not to like? This is actually part of a tutorial on the DevNet site, so you do have to register with them to be able to access this. I believe it's still free. So first thing we read on here is about Yang. Yang is a data model, so it's basically the kind of the schema or the framework for the data. It may be a bit like an object in programming. So Yang, it can be represented in a number of formats, including Yang language itself, XML, JSON, and HTML, JavaScript. So what we will be doing is using, we'll be using RESTCONF, which RESTCONF uses the data model. So the data model is actually being passed inside kind of the RESTCONF protocol. You may have heard of RESTCONF and NETCONF. RESTCONF is slightly newer and it uses JSON and port 443. We'll get to that in a second. So I've just logged into the sandbox. You can ordinarily to access a Cisco lab, like a pre-made lab with some devices all connected together, talking to each other, you would have to reserve it. But in this case, you don't have to reserve. So, and also with this sandbox, you don't even need to have VPN. It's VPNless access to a Cisco IOS XE device. What is an IOS XE device? Here it's a router. So it's like you would have at home or in your office, but bigger. Not necessarily bigger in size, but just with more options and more configuration possibilities. So we're talking about the Yang data models and NETCONF and RESTCONF. So Yang is effectively the data model. It's the structure of how the information is organized. And NETCONF and RESTCONF are more like the protocols which transport the Yang data model between you and the device that you're configuring. Little bit of housekeeping there. They just tell you not to do anything naughty. This, because there's no reservation required, you're not the only person using this potentially, so they're just telling you not to undo someone else's work. Right, so the host, on some of the other labs you would have to put in an IP address, and it, as we'll see in a minute with the GitHub repo, they use IP addresses, but we can actually use sandbox-rsxe-recom-1.cisco.com for the host. They've given us a username and password, so we'll be putting that into our code. And if we go over to the GitHub repo, so Cisco DevNet have got their own GitHub account, 753 repositories, 11 members. And I've just found this, Python code samples underscore network and RESTCONF. So RESTCONF is kind of the newer preferred protocol, really, because it enables you to use the requests library with JSON. You can see that was written in 2018. If you find some samples written in 2017, you may notice that there aren't any brackets around after the print statement. So yeah, some of the older stuff was written in Python 2.7. So this is called put hostname config, And what it allows us to do is put a new host name onto the device. Put as opposed to post, because it's already got a host name, so we're modifying it. So you need to do pip install requests if you haven't already done so. And yeah, you're off to the races. So you import requests, import sys. Sys is already within Python. Requests.packages URL lib3 disable warnings. That just, for testing purposes, it just stops you seeing loads of annoying warnings. The host, so that is what we saw as that big long name, which we'll copy and paste from the Cisco web page with that lab on. CAT 9300, that's just a model name that they were working on with their test script. This test script will work with what we want to do with our sandbox. And what we're going to do is copy that host name and the username and a password, and we're going to replace what they've got here. So we'll be replacing the Cisco and the 172.26, etc. The main method, so what it's doing is it's setting up a URL. The H in the curly braces is the H at the end, because it's the old kind of format string. So it's just substituting our capital letters host variable, which we're going to put in, and it will just go to that device /restconf/data, etc. That's the API endpoint. And we're just setting up headers just to say the content type is application/yang-data+json. Slightly different to what you may have seen with your usual API requests. Just copy and paste that. No need to do anything interesting there. And as you can see from the comment, RESTCONF media types for REST API headers. So RESTCONF is kind of Cisco's variant of a normal REST API request. Put, so we're using, instead of request.get or request post, we're using put, because we're amending editing the existing host name. So put, and then we use URL, which we've set up above, authorization, auth equals user and pass. The data is the payload. The payload is the new host. So host name is the key, and the value is what we're changing. So instead of catalyst 9300 in our code, we will go in and change that to be something that we can recognize and we know we've changed it. Verify equals false. If you're interested in what that's all about, go back to requests webpage and check it out. Verify equals false. It stops man in the middle attack, basically. So if you see here, SSL verification default. Defaults to true. Requiring or requests to verify the TLS certificate at the remote end. If verify is set to false, requests will accept any TLS certificate presented to this by the server, and will ignore hostname mismatches and or expired certificates, which will make your application vulnerable to man-in-the-middle attacks. Only set it to false for testing, but that's what we're doing, so we'll leave it on false. We don't want to see lots of errors and warning messages. We just want to prove this is kind of proof of concept. So this is the code in GitHub. Just go to raw, Control A, Control C will open up a new file in Vim. You can use VS Code, Nano, whatever text editor you like. And we're just going to paste that in, and we're going to modify the username, hostname, password, payload, and we'll strip out the comments. just really for brevity. So I'll just make the, hopefully that's readable, but I'll make the font just a tad bigger if that helps. There we go. So So looking fairly good. We just need to, in Vim, it's, I think it's probably you need to type 26DD, something like that. I'll get rid of the comments. So first comment, import the request library if you haven't already done so. Whether you're on Windows, Mac, Linux, all the same, pip install requests. Import sys, so that's already, you've already got that. You don't need to do pip install. Disable the warnings. Right, so let's go and change the host name. And CI, single quote, changes everything inside the single quotes if you're on Vim. And yeah, let's copy sandbox dash ioscxe, copy all that. You can paste it into Vim, just right click paste. Let's get the username. Again, go down to where it says Cisco CI single quote. Paste it in. Then the password, same. Cisco 12345, paste. Escape, and then we'll just go down a bit and we will change the payload. So that's the whole point of this. We want to change the host name. So obviously we're changing the host name, but in future we will be looking at more interesting stuff such as changing interfaces and changing more network settings, change some IP addresses and protocols and so on. So I'm just going to put Python 360YT. That's the payload. The payload is effectively changing what you see as the host name on the device. And everything else is as previously discussed by me in this video. So if you want to pause that and copy it yourself, or you could just go to the Cisco page and copy it and then just make the same three changes that I've done. The URL bit you could potentially change to an F string. I haven't done that yet, but it works. Trust me, this works. So that's the host name on a Linux box, and that's really what you're changing on the Cisco device. You're just changing the first thing you see when you log in. So what we'll do is we'll run this, we'll update the host name, we'll go and check it, and then we'll come back and we'll change the host name and we'll do it a second time. So let's run this. I'm just running Python. I've already set up an alias in my bash RC that's actually calling Python 3 just to avoid any confusion. I'm just trying to find that's my NETCONF script. That's an older script that I had earlier that I was using just to get the config. So rather than put the config, this is just an earlier script I had that gets the config, and it gets all of the config. So I could potentially improve that or edit it and make it just get the host name for me in due course. So I'm just going to scroll up through the entire config and try and find where it's got the host name. There's quite a lot of config, as you can see. Lots of it's because it's all kind of nested. There we go. Host name Python360YT. And again, I don't want to do anything too adventurous because we're on a shared sandbox. So run this. Edits. Let's go back up and edit the payload. So all we really need to do each time is just edit the payload. And the reason why the payload is just the key is just host name is because we've already traversed to it using the URL. Right, let's run this again. So this should update the host name to be 3. It will strip off the Python bit at the front and we'll just end up with 3. What was it? 3. See in a second. I'm actually dubbing this video over because first time I recorded it, the sound didn't record, but the video did. There we go, 390YT. That was the newer host name. So yeah, the API, kind of the endpoint, we specified within the URL. So if you wanted to change something else, you would slightly need to modify the endpoint that you were using in the URL. If you go on, go on this Cisco GitHub page, you will see more examples, more than what I've shown you. But I just wanted to cut, because this is now almost probably 4 years old, so I just wanted to just update it and just show the old code from 4 years ago still works with the Cisco sandbox as of 2022. So I hope this has been interesting. It's just showed you how you can use requests even with something you may never have come across, such as RESTCONF, NETCONF, YANG. So thanks for watching. Subscribe. See you again.